Hi everyone. Very good morning or afternoon or night, wherever you guys are. Today what I'm going to talk about is HMAN, which is RTK's novel portable arm rehabilitation solution that is designed to bring rehabilitation within everyone's reach. Before I go into the device, let me just share a bit about RTK's. So we are a company that develops robotic rehabilitation solutions. These solutions are designed for aging in place and for patients who may be suffering from sensory motor control deficits arising from injuries such as stroke or any other neurological injury. The key idea of our device is to enable training or therapy under minimal supervision, be it in a hospital or a clinical setting, a home-based setting, or even a community-based setting. As a company today, we are present across different parts of the globe. If you are in any of these regions and are interested to explore more with us, we are happy for you to connect with us at any point. There is a QR code at the end of this presentation for you to connect with us. Coming forward, so why as a company have we taken this route of ensuring that our solutions are usable at every stage? Because the simple idea is that the future of delivering therapy would be one where therapy is taken to the patient rather than therapy or the patient coming for therapy to an institution. And the idea of this would be that a patient can now get therapy wherever he or she is, be it in terms of location or stage of recovery, and at the same time still be in touch throughout this therapy phase or throughout this recovery path with their therapists, enabling them to have more confidence and more therapy, as well as be able to reach a life where they're able to be more independent. So to understand this path, what I will do is just to give you a bit of background. I'll take you through what is the existing rehab journey and what are the challenges that a system like this brings to the patients, and how as a solution HMAN helps in overcoming or bridging this gap. So to understand, first thing is we as a company started observing what is the journey a patient undertakes today. First thing is if he has any sort of an episode which requires him to be hospitalized, in that case his first, or there will be about a week to 2 weeks of inpatient therapy. During this, they will have interaction with one therapist and one specific set of tools. Post this, they are either discharged to their homes or they are discharged where they pursue therapy then in an outpatient center. It could be a rehab center or it could be any other outpatient department. And in this, they come across, they are undergoing therapy for a longer duration, be it few months, a year or so, with one therapist and again, a different set of tools. Post which, they might also be offered or they might also be encouraged to do home-based therapy. On this side of things, again, there will be a different set of tools and maybe they have also a therapist to connect. But one common thing we notice across all of this is that there is a lack of consistency in the kind of tools they have. There is a mismatch in the, not a mismatch, but let's say a lack of connectivity with one consistent therapy or therapist. And there is also a lack of objectivity that comes in terms of assessments, because as people may be aware, assessments today, clinical assessments are to a great degree subjective. And therefore, a patient might be recovering at different stages or may see different recovery parameters in different stages, which may affect their confidence in therapy. Now, if you look closer at what are the challenges today that the therapist or this whole system of a continuum faces, is that first, if you look at the therapist itself or the therapy providing system today, we see that it is highly intensive in terms of a one-to-one therapy. And because this is an intensive process, it is limiting the therapist on the number of patients they can see on a day-to-day basis. Now, this becomes an issue in countries which have a growing population base, and practically this is a situation seen in most developed or fast developing countries. Therefore, it will lead to a point where it will overburden the therapist, requiring them to find a solution to not just give the same quality of therapy, but also manage the same workload without getting overburdened or stressed out on themselves. This is on the therapist side. Now, if you look at the patient side, this presents another, the current system presents some challenges. First is if you are going to an outpatient center or you're going to a therapy center per se, This requires the patient to invest in time, invest in money, as well as the same for his family. And if you look at this process, it goes from few months to as much as a year or longer. And during this process, it tends to put a lot of pressure on the resources that the family or the patient's own relatives have to deploy in order for this therapy. Eventually, this will lead to a psychological pressure on the patient, forcing them to explore alternative paths of therapy, such as home-based therapy, which brings us to what happens when the patient takes therapy at home. The key aspect here is that the patient is asked to perform therapy exercises, and he does these exercises if there is somebody ensuring he does these exercises. But the current system does not afford this luxury, where it's left to the patient to try and do these exercises by themselves. Therefore, there is nobody tracking the amount of therapy. There's nobody tracking if the therapy is done at all. And there is nobody tracking how much is the recovery done. Therefore, a patient may just eventually lose motivation to do the entire therapy requirements or the therapy plan. So this is where it led to the development of alternative solutions. Primary angle was to look at how therapists can be catered to. And this led to the advent of robotics, right? So robotics has been there as a rehab device for the last 20 years or so, and it's always evolving, right? But so some benefits of having the robotics is that as a robot, you can increase the intensity of exercise. Robots are fantastic to do this, and it has been shown that if you're able to increase the intensity, the patient tends to learn faster as well. They are very good devices. Why? Because they can also provide a quantitative assessment, because now the device is able to assess how much is the improvement, what has been the patient's progress, and this whole thing can be made objective and therefore provide a clearer picture on how things are being on the patient side. The third benefit of having robotics is that they are a fantastic tool to complement the therapist's day-to-day workload. Today, there are enough robots that can do this, but all of these robots or none of these robots can be as a potential replacement. They are all just solutions to add on as a productivity tool to your therapy workflows. But the current set of robotics presents a unique challenge. That is, one, they are a complex device requiring the users or the therapist in this case to be very familiar, to undergo training courses just to be able to use the device. Second is they are bulky, they are big, they take up a lot of space in any rehab department, making it a bit difficult to be used in different departments. And last, these are highly expensive solutions simply owing to the complexity and the number of functions they offer. So if you look at this bigger picture, the robotics or the robotic rehabilitation devices that are present today are fantastic for institutions that have the financial capabilities and can have the space as well. So you would see that these devices are traditionally in bigger institutions, but let's say you go out to the smaller outpatient centers or even home-based settings, there is a shortage of robotic devices that can be used by the therapist. And this is what led us to imagine that what if, as a company, we could develop a solution that brings all of these same benefits of having a robotic device, but enable a patient to train in the absence of a therapist or under minimal supervision, and at the same time also be able to use this in their own homes or in a decentralized setting. This led us to the development of HMAN. In a nutshell, the HMAN today is a clinically validated device. We have done extensive trials to show that not only do the patients benefit clinically, but also therapist benefits in terms of workload, and the patients can be very comfortable with the usage of the device in a decentralized setting, such as a home-based setting. How does the device provide therapy? Is that it has an artificial intelligence algorithm that is adaptive in real time to the therapy needs of the patient. So as the patient trains on the device, he basically holds on to the handle, and once he's using the handle, as he uses the handle to train, he plays these games. Training games essentially, which are designed to promote learning, and as he starts playing them, the device is able to assess and adapt the therapy. For the patient, the games are very critical, so we have made sure that these games are very engaging, very immersive, and these are serious games that will help them or are more catered to the interests of the senior population and therefore motivate them to play more. Lastly, to ensure that the device is usable in each and every setting, we have made it a very compact and portable device that you can easily install on a tabletop at your home, in a hospital, or even beside the patient bedside. So as I was saying, who can use this device is patients who have sensory motor control deficits. These could be patients who seek neurological rehabilitation, orthopedic rehab, or even post-surgery rehabilitation. What is the key aspect of therapy delivery using the HMAN is the proprietary AI, which is an adaptive algorithm. As I was saying, it has been clinically validated and it is designed to promote recovery and learning for patients by its auto-adaptation. Therefore, at each and every point, the patient always is receiving therapy personalized and customized to his needs at that point. And secondly, this enables the therapist to manage better by bringing down his workload or her workload. Once the device is able to adapt to the requirements, the HMAN brings a unique function that is providing a physical guidance or a physical applied force that a patient experiences at his hand or on his arm when he is training with the device. The HMAN today sits in a very unique position because traditionally robotics, as I was saying, are seen in hospital or larger institutions, whereas for home-related or decentralized therapy, you would see traditionally V and Kinect-based devices, which provide no external engaging forces like the robotics does. This HMAN presents the same benefits of a robotics device in terms of an applied force, intelligence, and intensity. And this can be transferred to any decentralized setting, including home-based settings. But it also brings in the unique benefits of connectivity with a therapist that a V or a Kinect-based device does. So it's the perfect bridge for therapy across the continuum of care. As I was saying, it's a compact, lightweight device. This is an actual person holding the device and carrying it. It's 14 kilos. It offers a lot of benefits when, in especially today's settings, when there is a challenge of not allowing patients from different wards to intermingle in therapy. This makes providing therapy a lot of a challenging aspect for most institutions. Being compact and portable, the HMAN offers a unique advantage that now therapy can be taken to the different wards, and therefore patients can still continue to receive their requisite amount of therapy on a day-to-day basis. One key aspect we have focused on is if the device has to be compact and portable, it should also be easy to set up and very easy to use, such that it can be used by a TA or a therapist or anyone who is not even comfortable with traditional therapy, traditional robotic devices, but can be made very comfortable with this. What we've ensured is that the connections are highly simple. You can set the device up in few steps, as little as 3 steps, and start the therapy in as many as 5 clicks. So you can start for the patient in under 5 minutes. Traditionally, a lot of time that is lost is now saved because these steps have been simplified to a great degree. So why is the HMAN a smart choice for most therapists or patients or people looking to provide therapy across the continuum? Is that there are a lot of benefits, but maybe what I can do is I will just quickly give you 2 use cases that will exemplify what I'm trying to say. So the first one is basically the HMAN in a clinical setting in Singapore. The idea was that traditionally, as I was saying, they used to bring patients to the therapy room where they had this whole range of devices kept, and the patient would go through a therapy device at a time based on his plan. But due to COVID, these restrictions have applied, which do not allow patients from different departments or different wards to intermingle. And at times do not even, in certain centers, not even encouraged to bring them to the therapy room. HMAN, having HMAN in such an institution provided a lot of benefits. The therapists could now, or the TA could now take the device, as I was saying, to different departments, set it up there. And therefore, what they managed to do was, in a traditional 30, 35 minutes training per session, they have managed to provide 20 minutes of therapy with the device. And they have managed to do this for 5 days a week as compared to the additional 2 days. And this, they could increase the amount of therapy without having to increase their costs or having to increase their manpower to still maintain the quality of therapy saved. And what this has led to not only patients getting the requisite or more therapy, but also it's in time saving for the therapist to now manage more activities on a day-to-day basis. This is in a clinical-based setting. In a home-based setting, we were referred a patient who wanted to use a therapy device at home by their freelance therapist. The idea was the device was placed for more than one, for just about 1 month at his house, where he could train in the absence for about 30 days in the absence of the therapist. But the schedule was such that the therapist visited just 2 times per week, and throughout the rest of the week, the patient used the HMAN extensively. What we saw at the end of 1 month was that the patient improved very significantly in terms of score from 23 to 39 on their FMA. And this significance shows that a patient can benefit quite a bit by using the HMAN, even in the absence of therapist, because now his family members could set it up for him, and he had to simply follow the therapy plan that was done for that was set up for the patient. And because the games were engaging and the robot could assist or resist depending on the patient's requirements, he was still receiving his amount of requisite therapy during the patient during his therapy days or using the device, and the games made it engaging for him to extend or continuously train for extended duration. So this is about the HMAN. I am more than happy to share more with you guys. You can leave us an email, or you can scan the QR code and leave us your details. We would be very happy to connect with you and also share more about the device with you in this process. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me. In the meantime, Rio, if you can leave the QR code for about 30 seconds, it would be quite useful. Thank you so much for listening in.